Friends, we'll take up the discussion of second unit in strength of materials, or what is popularly called SOM. The second unit is center of gravity. Center of gravity and moment of inertia. Now, center of gravity of a lamina or a solid, it may be either a lamina or a solid. Now, for example, this is called a lamina. This is called rectangular lamina. Rectangular lamina, it may be triangular, square, circular, any shape. It can be of any shape. So, its center of gravity and moment of inertia are to be found out. Now, here, center of gravity is defined as a point. It is a point through which the mass of that lamina or solid acts. That is known as the center of gravity. When we are asked to find the center of gravity, what we have to do is we have to locate that point. We have to locate the point through which the its mass is acting. Now, to locate a point, you know, in analytical geometry, we require two reference lines which are called as the axis. Generally, what we do is, suppose we have I have a rectangular lamina. This is a rectangular lamina. This is its width, B. This is its depth, D. Now, the moment of inertia, the center of gravity of this lamina will be where these two diagonals meet each other. This you know, all of you know, that this point is called as the center of gravity. Now, to locate this point, what we do is we take this as one axis, that is the extreme left edge of the lamina will be taken as the y axis, and the bottommost edge of the lamina will be taken as the x axis. This will be taken as the x axis and this will be taken as the y axis, vertical axis. It is the leftmost edge of the given lamina and the bottommost edge is the horizontal axis. The left edge of the lamina is called as the vertical axis. Now, to locate this point, what we have to do is this distance and this distance must be given. You know, this distance is B by 2 and this distance is D by 2. By geometry, you know this. This is D by 2 and this is. So, the coordinates of this point will be B by 2, D by 2. This is how it should be given. Center of gravity is generally given like this. It is half the width here, half the depth here. This B is called the width and D is called the depth. So, like this it should be given. Now, this distance from here to here is called as the X bar and the distance from here to here is called as the Y bar. Now, in this case, the X bar is B by 2 and Y bar is D by 2. This is how it is to be given. So, this is for a rectangle, for a circle, for a triangle, for a square, how to find the center of gravity. You already know it in science. I think applied science we have done it. So, this center of gravity is this point. Now, here what we will be given is, we will be given a they have specifically mentioned that these four sections will be given, four shapes will be given, that is T section, I section, angle section or L section and the channel section. These three, four sections will be given. First, we have to find the center of gravity of these sections. Then that is x bar and y bar. If it is symmetrical, then we have to find either x bar or y bar. We will discuss that later. Then we have to find the moment of inertia. Suppose they have given a section like this. This is called as the L section. Now, first what we have to do is they will give all the dimensions of this, the length, width, everything will be given. First, we have to locate its center of gravity. So it will be, let us say, somewhere here. Then this is called the x-axis or the horizontal axis passing through the center of gravity, and this is called as the y-axis passing through the center of gravity. They will say find Ixx and Iyy, that is moment of inertia of this lamina about this axis and the moment of inertia about this axis. That is, if you want to rotate it about this axis, how much inertia or how much opposition is given, and if you want to rotate it about this axis, how much resistance is given. That is called as the moment of inertia. It is denoted by I. So first we will have to find out where is this point, that is locate the center of gravity. Then we will have to do this. Now, moment of inertia of some of these sections, usually what we get is a rectangular section. In problems, in numericals, we get rectangular section. Now we have to know these things. See, this is the section, rectangular section. So this is its center of gravity. Now this is B, this is D, width and depth. Now Ixx, that is moment of inertia about this axis, and Iyy are to be found out. Ixx will be BD cube by 12, BD cube by 12, and Iyy will be DB cube by 12, Iyy will be DB cube by 12. This is one thing that you must keep in mind. If it is about the vertical axis, it is DB cube by 12. If it is about the horizontal axis, it is BD cube by 12. B means this way, D means this way. Always B will be width, D will be depth, here also, there also. Now, suppose I want this to be shifted to this line, from this axis to this axis. I want to shift it from this axis to this axis. Then you must know what we call the parallel axis theorem. Now here we want to shift the moment of inertia of this rectangle from this axis to this axis, and these two are parallel to each other, and the distance between them is d by 2. This is the distance between them. If you know the distance between them, then you can shift the moment of inertia from this axis. I'll take this as xx axis, and this is AB, I'll say. Now I know Ixx is BD cube by 12. I have to shift it to AB. Now IAB will be equal to Ixx plus area of that figure, area of this rectangle whose moment of inertia I am shifting, multiplied by this distance. If you call this distance as generally x, this distance x, or we'll call that as y, vertical, into y square. Now IAB will be equal to Ixx will be BD cube by 12 plus A is B into D, area, it is a rectangle, so area will be B into D, y will be D by 2, the whole square. So this will be BD cube by 12 plus this will be BD cube by 4. 2 square is 4, D square, D square into D is D cube, BD cube by 4. Now the LCM here is 12. So 12 ones are, this will be BD cube plus 4 threes are, so 3 BD cube this will be. So then this will be 4 BD cube by 12 cancels. So this will be BD cube by 3. BD cube by 3. So if moment of inertia about this axis is BD cube by 12, about this axis it will be BD cube by 3. This is how the moment of inertia is shifted from one axis to another axis, which are mutually parallel to each other. This theorem we have to use anywhere. If you have two parallel axes, from one axis to the other axis, if you want to shift it, this is the formula. I about this axis will be equal to I about that axis plus area of the lamina into distance between, perpendicular distance between these two parallel lines, square of that will give you the shifting of the moment of inertia. This theorem we will use. So we have to solve some problems like this. On this thing, we'll solve a few problems from the question bank, and yet then you will be able to understand that. We'll take up a few problems from the question bank. I have taken these problems. First, I have taken problem number 4, question number 4 from the question bank. Determine the centroid of T section of a flange 100 mm by 10 mm. Also find the moment of inertia of the section about XX axis through the centroid. This is the problem. So they have given a T section. First, we will draw a rough figure. It need not be to the this thing. This is the T section. It need not be to dimension. This is the T section. It is 100 by 10. This is flange. This is called as the flange. This is called as the web. This is 100 mm. This dimension they have not given. We will take this also as 100 mm. I'll assume that also as 100 mm. And this is 10 mm. This is 10 mm. This is also 10 mm. Now, the problems that we will get are only I section, P section, L section and channel section, only these things. So you are in these, you are going to get only rectangular this thing. Now this should be divided into, what I will do is this, I will divide like this. This is its, this center of gravity is here. The center of gravity of this is here, somewhere here. Somewhere here, this is the diagonal, they are somewhere here. They both will be in the same line. Now, the center of gravity of the entire lamina will be somewhere here. This is the center of gravity. Now, this is one reference line. This is the left extreme edge. This is the another reference line. This is the x-axis. So, this distance is x bar and this distance is y bar. This is called as y bar. This is called as x bar. Now I will call one of them as 1 and the other one as 2. Anyone can be called as 1 and the other one becomes 2. If there are 3 rectangles, it will be 1, 2, 3. Now this section is symmetrical about this. T section means it will be symmetrical about y axis. That is, it is exactly half this side, exactly half that side. So we need not find out this distance. This distance, without calculating, we can say that it is 50 mm. That is 100 divided by 2. This distance will be half of 100. So we need not find out this. This need not be found out. In the case of T section and I section, we need not find out x bar, only y bar is to be found out. Okay, now this is 100, I have taken this, this as 2, this as 1. Now, the formula for finding x bar and y bar are, x bar is equal to a1 x1 plus a2 x2 plus a3 x3 etc. etc. If there are more than 2, then you will have to take all of them. Then this will be a1 plus a2 plus a3 etc. etc. If there are only 2, you will take 2. If there are 3, you will take 3. If there are 4, you will take 4. If there is a hole somewhere, you will take that as negative. Of course, you will not get such type of problem, I am telling. Here, A1 means area of first rectangle. That is, rectangle area, you know, is length into width is the area. Length is 100, width is 10. So, 100 into 10 it will be. A2 means area of the second rectangle. Here, we will take only this much. This is 90 into 10, so 900 mm square. So that will be A2. That is again a rectangle, length into width. Now x1 means you have taken this as 1. So the distance from here to here, the reference line is this. From here to here, what is its distance? That is x1. This is x2. This again is x2. Here both will be same because it is symmetrical. If you put the values there, you will get the same answer. So like that. Then y bar similar to x bar, y bar will be equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus etc. etc. divided by a1 plus a2 plus etc. etc. like that. Now, in this problem, I need not find out x bar. So, this is not necessary. Where I have to find out x bar, I will use that formula. Now, here, a1 means area of the first rectangle, that is 100 into 10, that is 1000 square mm. Now, a2 will be 90. I told you that this is not there, this 10 is not there. From here to here it is 90. 90 into 10, that is 900 square mm. You got it? So this is a1, that is a2. If there is one more rectangle, a3 also we have to find out. Next we have to find out y1 and y2. Y1 means from here, this is the reference line, here to here. Here to here, this is called as y1. This is called y1. Now, y1 will be equal to here, 90. That is, from here to here, it is 90 plus half of 10, 10 by 2. That is 95 mm. This is 95 mm. Then, y2 will be equal to, y2 will be equal to, this is y2 here, this is y2, it will be 90 divided by 2, that is 45 mm. So now I have a1, a2, y1, y2, you substitute these values here, you will get the value of y bar. So 1000, poor again. 1000 into 95 plus 900 into 45 divided by 1000 plus 900. So this will give you, let us see how much we will get. We will do here 1000 into 95 plus 900 into 45. Equals 1,35,500 divided by 1,900 will give me 71.3 mm. So that is, this distance is 71.3 mm. This I got now. this I got. So first what you have to do is, first you have to locate it. Then he wants, what does he want? He wants the moment of inertia of this about this axis, horizontal axis, xx axis. He wants that. Now, for that, what I will do is, I will take up like this. I'll rub this. I think you have understood this. Next, I xx of the entire lamina, will be moment of inertia of section 1, that is rectangle 1, about xx, about this axis, plus moment of inertia of the second rectangle about x axis, about the same axis. That will give you, if you add these two, you will get that. This will be b1 d1 cube divided by 12. That is, this is b1, this is d1 for this rectangle. Now, this will give me this moment of inertia about this axis, the axis passing through its center, plus b1 d1. That will give me the area of that, multiplied by the square of the distance between these two, that is y1 minus y bar the whole square. This is the moment of inertia of 1 about xx axis, rectangle 1 about xx axis. This b1 d1 cube by 12, understand, this is about this axis. From here it has to be transferred there. So for transferring, plus area of the rectangle 1, that is b1 d1, multiplied by square of the distance between these two. The square of the distance between these two is y1 minus y bar plus y1 minus y bar the whole square. Similarly, now for this rectangle, it will be b2 d2 cube divided by 12. That is about this axis, b2 d2 cube divided by 12 plus area of that rectangle. Area of that rectangle is b2 d2 into distance between these two, that is y bar minus y2 the whole square. This will give you the total moment of inertia. B1 is 100, B1 is 10 cube divided by 12, plus, do it slowly, 100 into 10 multiplied by y1, that is 95, minus y bar, that is 71.3 the whole square, plus b2 is 10 into d2, 90 cube divided by 12, plus 10 into 90 into y bar 71.3 minus y2 is 45 mm the whole square. So now slowly take your calculator, we can do it. First you do this, first you subtract it, 95 minus 71.3 equals 23.7 you get. Square of that, square of the answer, into 10, into 10, into 100, into 100. So we got this, plus 10 cube, 10 to the power of 3, 10 to the power of 3, into 100, 10 to the power of 3, 10 to the power of 3 into 100 divided by 12 will give me 570023 something, 57. Now if you press engineering, what will happen is it will be 570 into 10 to the power of 3, or it can be written as 0.57 into 10 to the power of 3, 10 to the power of 6, 10 to the power of 6 plus this one. Let us see. Similarly, 71.3 minus 45 equals 26.3, square of that, 691 point something into 90 into 10 or 900, 90 into 10 plus BD cube, 10 into 90 to the power of 3 divided by 12 equals, I get 1230021. It will be 1.23 into 10 to the power of 6. Now this will be this and this, you add 1.23 plus 0.57. If we add, we get 1.8 into 10 to the power of 6 mm to the power of 4. This is all that you have to do. 1.8 into 10 to the power of 6 mm to the power of 4. The unit of moment of inertia is mm to the power of 4, because this is in mm, this is also in mm, mm into mm cube, mm to the power of 4, this is also mm, this is mm square, here also mm square, it is also mm to the power of 4. So the unit of moment of inertia will be mm to the power of 4. This is it. This is the problem. We have solved one problem. Next, the second problem, I have taken the sixth problem from that. Find the CG of L section and moment of inertia of the section through CG and parallel to shorter leg. He has given this thing.